Now that we have an empty database, let's populate it with some information. With SQL, we would need to execute an insert command with all of the information we wanted to populate into our database. Using SQL Alchemy, creating a new database is as easy as creating a new object in Python. I will be executing these operations from the Python shell, but they could also be done from within a Python script. We must first import the following dependencies from SQL Alchemy and the empty database we created into our environment. We will see what they do in just a second. From our database setup.py file that we created, let's import our base, restaurant, and menu item classes. The create engine function lets our program know which database engine we want to communicate with. Then, let's bind the engine to the base class with the following command. This command just makes the connections between our class definitions and their corresponding tables within our database. The next thing I'm going to do is create a session maker object. This establishes a link of communication between our code executions and the engine we just created. In order to create, read, update, or delete information on our database, SQL Alchemy executes database operations via an interface called a session. A session allows us to write down all the commands we want to execute, but not send them to the database until we call a commit. Here, I'll show you what I mean. I'm going to create an instance of a DB session and call it session for short. From now on, when I want to make a change to my database, I can do it just by calling a method from within session. The dbSession object gives me a staging zone for all of the objects loaded into the database session object. Any change made to the objects in the session won't be persisted into the database until I call session.commit. Now, as I promised, making a new entry in our database is as easy as making a new object in Python. Take a look at these three lines of example code and watch as I implement them to create a new restaurant in my database. Following this example, I'll make my first restaurant like so. As you can see, it's just an instance of my restaurant class with the name attribute I decided to give it, Pizza Palace. To persist my new restaurant into the database, I must do two more session operations. First, by calling session.add my first restaurant, my restaurant object is in the staging zone to be added to the database. Then, with session.commit, it's now stored to my database. But how do I know it worked? Well, I can also use the session to interact with my database and see what's inside of it. If I execute session.queryRestaurant.all, I'm asking my session to go into the database, find the table that corresponds to the restaurant class, and find all the entries in that table and return them in a list. When I run this, I get a response with something like database setup restaurant object at and some hexadecimal number. This just lets us know that Python found a restaurant in our database and represents it as an object at this location in memory. I'm sure you're thinking, well, that's great, but how is it useful to me? We'll go into more detail about the query method when we focus on reading data out of our database. So now, let's add a menu item to our Pizza Palace menu. Since our menu items all belong to a restaurant and have a few more attributes, we have to provide a bit more information in our declaration. I can create a cheese pizza by executing the following command. Notice that I provided all of the fields of information for a menu item here and specified a foreign key relationship to the object name of my restaurant. In order for this operation to work, I didn't have to fill out every entry unless I specified it as nullable equal to false in our database setup.py file. Now let's run session.queryMenuItem.all to see that an object now exists for our cheese pizza item as well. Now that you know how to add data to a database, it's your turn to get some practice at it.